Today let us take up varietal classification of rice based on LB ratio. So the variety, how the variety is fixed, that we are going to see. It is purely based on length, the measurement of length in millimeter and the measurement of breadth in millimeter, the length divided by breadth, that gives ratio. Based on this ratio the variety is fixed. And now the prevalent variety is grade A and common. So we will see all the things. First we will see some of the introductory remarks. So Ramya committee was formed for the classification of variety, and according to Ramya committee the variety was classified into 6 varieties, that is long slender, long bold, medium slender, medium bold, and short slender, short bold. So totally 6 varieties were there, and the complexity was felt in that classification. And next Balasubramanian committee was formed. According to Balasubramanian committee, basing on LB ratio, they have classified the variety into 3, that is super fine, fine and common. Even this was so complex, and there might be much difference between fine and super fine, so they wanted to make it as mingling the fine and super fine. It has been made as grade A and the common. So totally only 2 varieties now at present, only 2 varieties are made available or basing on the LB ratio. So that we are going to see how it is being made. And regarding variety, we want to say something about variety. The market variety is something different. In market so many varieties are available, that is Pony and ADT 31, the CO 25, CO 33, at Tirurkupam, Bapatla, PR. So like that, basing on the research center where it was released. Say for example, Aadudurai ADT. ADT means Aadudurai Paddy Research Center. So they have released some varieties, so it is called ADT. Like that, Coimbatore Agriculture Research Center and Agriculture College is there. They have released some variety that is called CO. Similarly, Tirurkupam, they have released some variety and that is called TKM variety, and Payanur, POR, like that, so many varieties are available. Like that in Andhra, in Guntur, nearer to Guntur, Bapatla Agriculture College is there, Agriculture Research Center is there, they are releasing some varieties that is called Bapatla, like that Pammal, Punjab Rice, PR, and international variety IE. So like that, so many varieties are available in the market. But as regards FCI, it is nothing to do with the procurement of the rice. So only 2 grade A and common variety is fixed, and basing on that only the procurement is made and the payment is also made. The difference between grade A and common will be 50 rupees. So the approximately 50 rupees, and then some of the market variety, though it stands for common, it will be of while cooking, it will be the length will expand like anything. And for example, Mulukulu, it will stand for common, but it expands, and actually it should be fixed in grade A, but LB ratio, it will not stand for LB ratio, that's why it is classified as common. So like that, some of the varieties available in market is of having better cooking quality than the rice of common and grade A. And moreover, the oldest, the traditional variety will be very good in cooking quality and keeping quality, that is the old rice. If we soak in water, the old rice will be very tasty and other thing as regards traditional variety. the new varieties will not withstand the overnight soaking, and it will not be that much tasty because these are all hybrid varieties. Hybrid varieties were made basing on the quantum of the paddy which we obtain as output of harvest. So maximum harvest we want, that's why the quantum is increased, that's why we made hybrid, a lot of hybrid varieties. And these hybrid varieties are giving better yield than the normal traditional varieties such as Samba, so many varieties are there, that traditional variety that we are not sowing and we are not harvesting all those things because of less quantum of output in the yield. So this is with regard to the some of the introduction, and now we are going to see how the actual classification is made. First we will see what is meant by authenticated sample. Authenticated sample means the sample which have 90% of purity, 90% of purity, and collected from rice research center is known as authenticated sample, and that will have 90% purity, and the variety is fixed by the government of India even before releasing the variety. That is called notified variety. Only the notified variety are available in the market, and that alone should be procured by FCI or any other agencies. So before coming to the market, all varieties are notified by the government of India basing on the LB ratio. Now how the variety is fixed? So the authenticated sample, 3 kgs of paddy is obtained, 3 kgs of paddy, and then that is hulled and shelled and hulled, and the rice obtained is called brown rice. Brown rice owing to the bran which has brown in color. Then this brown rice is say for example 2 ton probably for 700 grams, 2.1 brown rice may be 2.100 grams, 2 kgs, 2 kgs and 100 grams rice approximately we may get. And this brown rice is put in the sample divider. Sample divider is a device which will divide the sample equally in all its refractions, intact in each of its division. It will divide into two. Suppose if you put 2.100, it will make it as 1.50 grams, 1 kg 50 grams. In another pair we will get 1.0 like that. Similarly, again if you put 1 kg, then it will be divided into 500 approximately 500 grams. So this is the way we have to get 500 grams of sample as a resultant sample which will be taken for the analysis. Then brown rice 2.100 grams, then this will be put into sample divider. Is nothing but it is a physical device which divide the sample into equally into two halves basing on the gravitational force. A funnel like structure will be there, and then a conical structure will be there, then two spout will be there, two pipes will be there, and this is arranged in a strand, and here two pans will be there. When we put a sample here, then here so many slots will be there, and through that slots by gravitational force the sample is divided into two equally in all its refractions equally. That is sample divided, and we obtain 500 gram sample or half kg sample, 500 gram sample. Then from this 500 sample, what we do, we make it as we spread it in a circular fashion, and 9 place sampling is taken from that. So we spread the rice, and from that rice we take 9 place sampling. That 9 place sampling is equivalent to 20 grams we have to take it. 20 grams. This 20 grams, from this we divide, we remove all the fractions like brokens, and then the foreign matter, red grains, and then admixture, and then damage, discolored, all these things we have to remove, and then head rice. So the head rice is free from all the refractions. So this head rice we have to take it. From this head rice we have to take 2 grams, and this 2 gram sample is taken for LB ratio. Approximately this will be having some 102 grams, means on, in 3 grams it will be around, in 5 grams it will be around 300, in 2 grams it will be 120, like that. So that grains are taken for LB ratio measurement. So each and every grain we have to measure the LB ratio. So we in a paper we have to tabulate all the things. What is the length? Say for example 6 millimeter, breadth is 2 millimeter, then LB ratio is 3. So this is more than LB ratio is 6 by 2 is equal to 3. When it is more than 2.5, then it is classified as grade A. And then less than 2.5, say for example length is 5, breadth is 2.5, ratio L by B ratio is 2, this is classified as common. So basing on this, the variety is fixed, and after taking the admixture should not exceed 6%. So the admixture, if more than 6% is there, that should be downgraded as common. So in the head rice, there should not be any admixture. The 100% purity should be there as regards variety. All, suppose if it is 120 rice is there, all 120 should stand for the above 2.5, that is grade A, if it is common, no botheration. Below 2.5, then even if it is more or less, that is more than 6% is there or 10% is there, that should be classified as common. So as regards common, there may not be any problem. When it is more than 6%, it should be classified as common. That is, the LB ratio more than 2.5, it should be classified as grade A, and less than 2.5, it should be classified as common. So this is how the government of India classify the variety. Then in FC, the same thing is adopted. Suppose 1 kg sample is taken, from the 1 kg of rice is taken. In FC, during procurement time, if it all in uniform fashion, then we are not suspecting any. On seeing the variety, we can identify whether it will stand for LB ratio or not. So if we suspect it, then we have to take 1 kg of rice. Then what we have to do, that 1 kg of rice will be divided into, in sample divider we will put it, and it is made as 500 gram sample. Then we take 20 grams from that, that is gravimetric. From that each and everything is weighed. The head rice is, from the head rice we have to take 2 grams, the LB ratio is to be found out. So LB ratio, then a chart we have to prepare. Then each and every rice, what is LB ratio? That is, as regards in FCI we are doing it. So how we are measuring the length, breadth, that is a pertinent issue. We are measuring the rice length. Usually the rice will be like this. Here it is, the germ portion removed. The germ portion is removed, and that's why it will be like that. This is length. So the up to this one is length, then this is breadth, this is breadth, and the another thing will be there, that is called thickness. Thickness will be somewhat lesser than the breadth. In rarely some of the varieties both the breadth and thickness will be same, like Rajamudi, something, some of the varieties, rare varieties will be both the breadth and thickness will be coincident. But in most of the cases, the length will be more and breadth will be more, thickness will be very less. So this is this we have to measure it with the help of digital vernier caliper. Now the digital caliper is available, and if you put it, automatically it should show. Suppose in scale and other thing we cannot measure accurately. Suppose say it is 6 millimeter, but in digital meter it will go showing 6.06 or 6.16, 6.20, so like that it will show. Like that breadth also we have to measure it, and that will show as 2.01, 2.20, 2.25, like that. So length by breadth we have to divide it, then we will obtain the LB ratio. This is the method we are adopting to classify the variety. Then we will be then with regard to the rice, these things, LB, length, breadth, thickness, these things are also very important. Then the other things are so I think we have covered all the things, and then the committee also we have told all the things, and at the time of procurement we should be very careful in fixing the variety. Suppose if it is common in grade A, if common is more than 6% or 10% like that, then it should be downgraded as common. So it should not be even say 90% purity is there, that is grade A, it stands for grade A. It should be 10% is admixture, then it should be downgraded as grade A. I think we have covered all the things. With this we conclude this video.